Well, now, when does one make dua or ask Allah for specifically for forgiveness?
Forgiveness.
Is it during your sujood or is it after the salah?
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Both is correct. It's like changing dua for a dozen. After the salah, it is after a good deed. In tahajjud, Rasulullah says, As-salatu mi'raj al-mu'min. The salah is the mi'raj of a believer. So you can make it in your ruku, you can make it in your sajida. Many of the ulama said, you know, when you go in sajida, you are the nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're the nearest to the ground, but it's also the nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spiritually. So when you're going to sujood, yes, the sunnah to read subhanahu rabbi al-a'la wa bihamdi. But if also important to just say rabbi khfirli. And if you the jalsa, the something between the two sujoods, is also that dua, if you understand the dua, Rabbi ghfirli wa rahamni wa jaburni wa rzuqni wa hdini wa afini wa'afu anni. Wa'afu anni also means forgive me. Rabbi ghfirli, so Allah forgive me. Say it with that intention, oh Allah forgive me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, it break by the malaika. When you say, La yaghfiru dhunuba illa anta. No one can forgive me but Allah. He smiled with the malaika. Even so much so, Rasulullah Sallam taught us, when you read, La yaghfiru dhunuba illa anta, smile with those who are next to you or near you. Because Allah smiled with the malaika, where he says, you see my bandar, you see my slave, my ibad, they are asking me forgiveness. They are saying, La yaghfiru dhunuba, nobody can forgive my sins illa anta, except me, Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. And that we should take every time advantage of it. When you read, therefore, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a person reads istighfar, Allah even give you more money. If there's drought, read istighfar, Allah send the rain torrential. When you do planting, you don't have to have green fingers. When you plant, you also, some people like was gardening, ne? Right? So don't think you go with green fingers. Read astaghfirullah. In Surah Nuh, Allah Ta'ala says, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Say astaghfirullah to me, say Allah. Because Allah is the ghafuru rahim. He is ghafar, the extreme form of forgiveness. People will not forgive you. Allah will forgive you. People will speak about your bad things. Allah will speak about your good things. إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Yursili sama'a alaykum midrara. When there's drought, make istighfar. Ulama teach us, make istighfar. Allah will send down a rain in torrential. An abundance. Then also, if you don't have children, and you want children, read istighfar. If you want money, Allah will increase your money, your financial situation, and Allah will also increase your progeny. So istighfar is one of the best form of making dhikr and asking Allah for forgiveness. The second part of istighfar, the Quran says, مَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will not destroy this ummah of yours as long as you are amongst them. People of Nuh, Allah destroyed them while Nuh was alive. People of Nabi Salih, Nabi Lut, Allah destroyed them while they were part of the nation. Allah promised Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I will not destroy your nation as long as you are amongst them. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. And Allah will not destroy this ummah as long as someone says, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. Allah forgive us all.
Ameen.